மாஷால்லா. அடுத்ததாக வரிசை எண் 15. தந்தை பெயர் முபாரக், அவர்களுடைய மகள் ஹப்சா கான். கல்வி என்ற தலைப்பில் ஆங்கிலத்தில் பேச வருகிறார்.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تعالى في القرآن العظيم والفرقان المجيد: فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق، خلق الإنسان من علق، اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم، علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. وقد قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: طلب العلم فريضة على كل مسلم. رواه ابن ماجه. Respected ulamas and my dear sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. It is by the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we all gathered here. And it's my great pleasure to give a short speech on the topic ilm, knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded knowledge to the mankind, which are just people, to seek knowledge. اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق. Recite in the name of your Lord who created. This verse highlights the importance of reading, elevates the standing of knowledge, and urges its pursuit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also asks in Holy Quran in Surah Az-Zumar, verse number 9. هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Are those who know and those who not know same? No, they are not the same. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, طَلَبَ الْعِلْمُ فَرِيضَةٌ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ. Seeking knowledge is an obligatory upon every Muslim. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam commanded knowledge upon all Muslims and urged them to seek knowledge as far as they could reach and seek it at all times. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam also said, مَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَطْلُبُ فِيهِ عِلْمًا سَلَكَ اللَّهُ طَرِيقًا مِّنْ طَرَقِ الْجَنَّةِ. Whoever treads a path to seek knowledge, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes a path easier for him towards Jannah. Aisha bint Abu Bakr radiallahu anhuma, she is portrayed as scholarly and inquisitive. She is known for narrating 2,210 hadith. MashaAllah. She spent her days in fasting, charity, and living modestly while spreading knowledge. She was the most influential female among the male companion. Az-Zuhri rahmahullah said, if Aisha radiallahu anha's knowledge is compiled and compared to the knowledge of all women, her knowledge would have surely excelled their knowledge. The amount of knowledge of Prophet's intimate life that Aisha radiallahu anha narrated couldn't be narrated by any other male companion. Abu Musa al-Ashari radiallahu anha said, whenever there was a hadith which was unclear and they would ask Aisha radiallahu anha about that, they would always gain knowledge about the hadith from her. Hafsa bint Umar radiallahu anhuma, she is the first woman to memorize the Quran by heart, mashaAllah. She was inquisitive by nature and would never shy away from asking a question for her quest of knowledge. Do you know the first and the oldest university in the world, which is the University of Al-Qarawiyyin, which was founded by a Muslim woman? She is Fatima Al-Fihri. Fatima developed a masjid and an institution in 8th century, which later became the University of Al-Qarawiyyin. Today, it is recognized as the oldest university in the world by UNESCO and the Guinness World Record. During the golden age of Khilafat, usually the period between 8th and 13th century, is when Western Europe was intellectually stagnant and backward, Islamic scholarship flourished with an impressive openness in traditional science, art, or even literature. Other outstanding contributions were also made in areas such as botany, chemistry, maths, physics, etc. Ilm is the context of Islam. It is regarded as a process of a complete person, spiritually, rationally, and in all dimensions. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, when a man dies, all his deeds come to an end except for the three: an ongoing charity, which is sadaqatul jariyah, علم النافع, which is beneficial knowledge, and a righteous son who prays for his parents. رواه البخاري. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all with sacred knowledge. Ameen. ربي زدني علما, ربي زدني علما, ربي زدني علما. اللهم إني أسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا. اللهم انفعني بما علمتني وعلمتني ما ينفعني وزدني علما. وآخر دعوانا عن الحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاك الله خيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.